and welcome to the Massillon McKinley game. I'm extremely excited for this one. I'm Zach Hamilton, your play-by-play announcer, here with Rachel Wuske, your color commentator. Rachel, how are you feeling about this game today?
I am super excited. It's always exciting to be at a Massillon McKinley game, and I'm so excited to see what happens.
Very, very excited to see these Tigers run through the banner. Hopefully take the victory on this one. Through the Tiger season, starting right from the beginning, it's like basically every game that they do works up to this very moment. A very, very important rivalry to both of these schools. It's just a very, very big moment, and I know there's thousands of people that love to watch this and physically be here and see this game go. And very, very excited to see who wins. It's gonna be a great game for sure.
Yep, we've been working up to this all week with rallies and blood drives. We're always excited to see what happens.
Here come the Massillon Tigers, holding up the Tiger flag and the American flag with their balloons coming up. Coming right through that banner, as well as the McKinley Bulldogs coming through.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have not already done so, please rise and remove your hats. An important part of the greatest rivalry in high school football, which is McKinley versus Massillon, is paying respect to our country with our national anthem.
we're going to go ahead and get this game underway here. It looks like Masson's going to be receiving the kickoff here with Austin Brawley, as well as Camden Beasley in the back, ready to receive the kickoff.
That team for the Tigers, number 4, senior Austin Brawley, number 16, senior Camden Beasley, set the kickoff for the McKinley Bulldogs, senior number 6, Ala Saad.
Looks like they're going to have number 6, Ala Saad, on the kickoff for McKinley. That one's going to get kicked right out of bounds. Got Jalen Slaughter coming out to fill in the quarterback position for the game today. We're going to get this magnificent rivalry going. First and 10 on the 35-yard line. Slaughter receives a snap. Hands it off to number 16, Camden Beasley. Runs up the middle and gets stopped right where they were just at.
Leading the defensive charge for the Bulldogs, number 22, junior Jamar Barsick. Injured player, timeout on the field.
Seems to be an injured player.
Being attended to.
First play of the game.
The long snapper and defensive standout senior, Yamaya Saibahia.
Now second and 8 on the 37-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, hands it off to Cameron Beasley, runs up the middle, finds a little bit of an open space, and gains a good few yards for the Massillon Tigers. Great run. Camden Beasley, number 16 on the Massillon Tigers.
Gain of 4 on that play. Third down and 4. All at the Massillon 41-yard line.
Now third and 4 on the 41-yard line. Slaughter receives a snap. Looks like Camden Beasley. Looks like it was a fumble. Slaughter was able to go and grab that ball before the Bulldogs get anywhere near it. It was a great save by Jalen Slaughter, number two.
Number 89, senior Stephen McNeil.
Looks like they're going to go ahead and punt it away. Fourth down here, 37-yard line. Darius McElroy ready to punt it away for the Tigers. Punt is off. Decently far down the field, and it's going to go off out of bounds. As you can hear, the McKinley fans going absolutely insane. First and 10 on the 40-yard line for the Bulldogs.
First and 10, Bulldogs from the McKinley 40.
Got number four, Amarion Williams, as the quarterback for the McKinley Bulldogs. So it's going to be a handoff, run straight up the middle. Looks like they got tackled just right where they stood. Might have been a gain of about a yard or so.
Off the bottom of the pile for the Tigers, number 16, Camden Beasley. Call it no gain on the play, second down, 10.
Looks like it was no gain on that play right there. Sees a snap. He's going to pass it over to left to number five. He's going to get a good few yards from the Tigers. Looks like they cannot take him down. He gets pushed out of bounds by the Massillon Tigers, just shy of the 30-yard line. It's a pretty big gain of the yards for the McKinley Bulldogs. Looks as though the Tigers grabbed on something around his waist, but was not able to take him down immediately. Now first and 10 on the 35-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap, handoff.
Chris Williams, the ball carrier.
The handoff to number 26, Chris Williams. Now second and 11 on the 36-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives that snap. He's going to hand it off to Chris Williams. The Bulldogs are going to get a good few yards for the Bulldogs. It's a great stop, though, by Austin Brawley and Ryan Zinkovic right there, though. Prevent them to get even more yards. Now third and four in the 29-yard line.
We'll be back after this word from Stark State College.
Saving money is more important than ever. and Stark State College is here to help. With more than half off your tuition for the spring semester, apply now and receive $100 off each credit hour, any major, online or on campus. Gain the skills to head directly into a good-paying job, or take your credits and transfer to a bachelor's degree program. Either way, you'll save thousands on a high-quality education. Find out more at starkstate.edu/half off.
At Sargent Clean's Car Wash, they know you have a lot of choices when it comes to getting your car clean. That's why, at Sargent Clean's Car Wash, you can count on their hardworking team members to make your car washing experience the best. They offer unlimited monthly plans and free vacuums that will help keep your vehicle looking showroom new. Sargent Clean's Car Wash is veteran-owned and is proud to be a part of the Massillon community. Another great car washing experience is waiting for you at Sargent Clean's Car Wash in Massillon.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Stark State College and Sargent Clean's Car Wash.
Third and four on the 29-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Scrambling forward just a little bit. Looks like it's going to be an incomplete pass by the Bulldogs. Pass was intended for number five, Harold Finnan Jr.
There are flags on the play, though. I'm guessing that they're going to say pass interference. Holding on Massillon, which gives McKinley a first down.
Now first and 10 on the 13-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap, hands it off to Chris Williams. With a run out right just a little bit. Almost got tackled. Looks like the McKinley Bulldogs are going to get a touchdown. Able to find that open space. I thought he was going to get tackled right there, but he was able just to slip right out of one of the Massillon Tigers' hands and get that touchdown for the McKinley Bulldogs. They're going to go for the extra point here. Kicker number six, Al-Assad.
Flag on the play. Dead ball on defense.
The kick was blocked a little bit there by number four, Austin Brawley, which has quite a record of blocking the kicks just for the whole entire season. Now, McKinley Bulldogs 6, Tigers 0.
We'll be back after this word from Massillon Boys and Girls Club.
The Boys and Girls Club of Massillon has been at the forefront of youth development, instilling a sense of competence, usefulness, belonging, and influence. The greatest contributions to the lives of our youth, our communities, our nation, and the world are the life lessons taught every moment of every hour of every club day. The youth of today become the leaders of tomorrow. Great futures start here.
Welcome back. Thanks again to the Massillon Boys and Girls Club.
The McKinley Bulldogs are going to go ahead and kick it off with Al-Assad, number 6, kicking it off for the McKinley Bulldogs with 8 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. Austin Barley and Kim Beasley in the back ready to receive the kickoff. Austin Barley receives that one right there. He's going up the field, finding a little bit of an open space.
Tackle made, number 27, sophomore.
He was tackled at the 35-yard line.
Tigers' second possession of the game begins at the Massillon 35-yard line.
Now first and 10 on the 35-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, hands it off. To a run right up the middle. Looks like they're struggling to take him down. Handoff was to number 20, Freddie Lennox Jr. So it was a gain of 3 yards for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, hands it off. Freddie Lennox Jr. runs up the middle, finds a little bit of an open space. He gains a few yards for the Massillon Tigers.
Senior number 3 on the stop. At the 42-yard line, gain of 4, third down and 2.
Now third and 2 on the 43-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. The handoff, we're in strip the middle. Looks like that was a possible gain of about a yard or two for the Tigers.
Harold Fannin Jr. on the stop.
Just enough to get them the first down.
Tigers. Ball at the Massillon 45-yard line.
Now first and 10 on the 45-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Pass over to the left side. Catch by Austin Brawley, number 4. Able to gain a few yards for the Massillon Tigers. A great catch by Austin Brawley.
Sincere McNeil. Ball in the Bulldog territory at the 49-yard line. Gain of 6, second and 4.
Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Freddie Lennox Jr. He runs up the middle, finding an open space, getting to the 20, to the 10, to the 5, to the Massillon Tiger. Touchdown! Finding the open space and a great run right through to getting a Massillon Tiger touchdown. Rachel, how are you feeling about that
one? I'm feeling great. I'm so excited we got a touchdown, and we're just going to keep getting more and more.
That's what I'm hoping for. It's definitely a great run, able to outrun half of the McKinley Bulldogs that were chasing after him. That was awesome.
Great.
Looks like we're now going to go for the extra point. We've got number one, Shane Rue, going to kick it off for the extra point. Kick is up. And the kick is good. Now the Massillon Tigers 7, McKinley Bulldogs 6.
We'll be back after this word from Cosmo's Grill.
Hungry for a great lunch or dinner? Then it's time to head to Cosmo's Grill in downtown Massillon. You'll enjoy their friendly, welcoming atmosphere and their hardworking waitstaff. At Cosmo's Grill, their large menu offers you a great selection of appetizers, soups, salads, entrees, and more. For a special treat, order one of their mouth-watering Hearthstone baked pizzas, cooked up fresh and delicious every time. Carryout and curbside pickup are both available at Cosmo's Grill, located in downtown Massillon.
If you're like most people, your life is a series of brushstrokes, large and small. Moments from the everyday to the extraordinary. As you move through your world, let Grange Insurance and an independent agent put the finishing touches on an insurance plan to meet your needs. Now, that's a stroke of genius.
Buell and Oliveri Insurance is your Grange independent agent in Massillon. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, call or visit our website today.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Cosmo's Grill and Buell and Oliveri Insurance.
Coming back from those spots, we now have 5 minutes and 53 seconds to go left in the first quarter. This first quarter is actually going by pretty fast. We're going to have the Massillon Tigers kicking it off with number one, Shane Rue, as the for the kicker for the Massillon Tigers.
Backing for the Bulldogs, number 2, Caleb Ruffin. Number 26, Chris Williams. The kickoff for the Tigers, number 1, Shane Rue.
Rue kicks off the ball. The far one down the field. He's going to get caught by the McKinley Bulldogs. He's going to get taken down just shy of the 25-yard line.
Leading the special teams charge for the Tigers, number 33, sophomore Cole Fair.
That's going to be 1st and 10 on the 24-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap, hands it off to number 21, Trayvon Mackey. Looks like it was an immediate stop by the Massillon Tigers.
Number 16,
5 minutes and 32 seconds to go in the first quarter. Bulldogs 6, Tigers 7. Williams receives a snap, hands it off to Mackey.
Second consecutive carry for Trayton Mackey.
Looks like that was about a gain of about a yard or two for the Bulldogs. But another just about immediate stop by the Massillon Tigers. The defense is doing very, very well. They're making sure they get them down right away as fast as they possibly can. Williams receives a snap, hands it off to Mackey. Another run straight up the middle. Looks like they're going to gain some yards for the Bulldogs.
junior defensive lineman Marcus Moore. They bring a fourth down and five on the 29. The punter is Al-Assad. And back deep, number four, Austin Brown.
Now, fourth down and five on the 29-yard line. Looks like they're going to punt this one away. Number six, Al-Assad. It looks like the Mass Tigers had to break through. Al-Assad faking that. Almost had to, he had to stop that punt there and had to just start running. First from the 43-yard line for the Bulldogs. Number 15, Keaton Road receives a snap. Looks like that was an attempt to hand off. Attempt to hand off to number 26, Chris Williams, but he dropped that one.
Corrections, those are orange.
The Tigers were able to recover it.
It will be Tigers football. It will be first and 10, Massillon.
It's now the Tigers' ball, first and 10 on the 45-yard line.
The officials place the football at the Tigers' 45.
Slaughter coming back out. Slaughter receives a snap. Fake handoff. He's going to pass it all the way down the field to number 18, Ardell Banks. I mean, incomplete pass. Looks like that was double coverage on him. Now second and 10 on the 45-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Freddie Lennox Jr. Martin straight to the middle. Looks like that was a gain of a yard for the Massillon Tigers.
Gain of two, third down and eight.
Gain of 2 yards for the Massillon Tigers. Now third and eight on the 47-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. It's a fake handoff. He's going to go over to the left to find somebody to pass it to. It's going to be caught by number 21, Jaden Welch. Gain those extra yards for the Massillon Tigers.
On the tackle, Colin Wilson, number nine, a senior.
It's going to be just enough to get them that first down. Now first and 10 on the 41-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Lennox Jr. He's going to find an open space in that left pocket. Going to gain even more yards for the Massillon Tigers, inching their way closer and closer to a touchdown. Now second and three on the 34-yard line for the Tigers.
Second down three from the McKinley
34. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Lennox Jr. a run right up the middle, able to gain a few yards for the Tigers.
Number 8, junior linebacker Brian Foster. Sam Snodgrass, number 53, a sophomore lineman, is a player being treated.
We'll be back after this word from Doring Vision Center.
Proper eye care is important. Doring Vision Center in downtown Massillon is a primary care optometry clinic. They use the latest technology and can treat most eye disease conditions. Doring Vision Center welcomes emergency eye visits and same-day appointments may be available. Most insurances are accepted, including government plans. Don't forget their optical showroom, featuring a wide variety of frames.
From everyone at Doring Vision Center,
go Tigers!
Welcome back. Thanks again to Doring Vision Center.
Let's come back now. We have 2 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the first quarter. Third and 3 on the 34-yard line. Sutter receives a snap. Hands it off to Lennox Jr. Looks like it was a fumble and a recovery by the McKinley Bulldogs. First and 10 on the 34-yard line for the Bulldogs. 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Keaton Rode out here for the quarterback position. Rode receives the snap, hands it off to Williams. Loss of 2 yards. Now second and 12 on the 32-yard line. Rode receives a snap. A fake handoff. Looks like the Tigers are breaking through. He's struggling to find somebody. Has to end up running out of bounds.
There's a flag on the play. In the backfield there. The flag is on McKinley. They're going to talk about it.
As they always do. We love to build the suspense for us.
I think. It was holding. Holding on McKinley.
Now, second and 12 on the. Looks like it's going to be. Second 30 on the 14-yard line for the Bulldogs. Rode receives a snap. Fake handoff. Pass to number 10 on the Bulldogs. Pass is complete. He's going to get pushed back a little before they call the play. Pass was complete to number 10, Sincere McNeil. Now third and 20 on the 24-yard line with 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Road receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Scrambles off to the right side. He's going to throw it out of bounds. Incomplete pass.
It's junior on the coverage. Running situation for McKinley.
Now 18 seconds to go in the first quarter. It's going to bring the Bulldogs to fourth down now. Looks like they're going to punt this one away. Number 6, Al-Assad. Bulldogs punting it off for them. We got Austin Brawley in the back ready to receive this punt. Be a short one. He's going to pick that one up. Go to the 40, 50, 40-yard line. Going to get practically dragged out of bounds. Mini fight almost on the field.
Hitting the defensive effort, Garden Foster from the Bulldogs. Let's check out the penalty.
Very, very heated play right there.
Holding on Massillon.
It's now first and 10 on the 32-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, a handoff to Camden Beasley. Finds an open space in the middle. Able to scramble down the field to get those extra few yards for the Tigers. It almost looked like he was going to get tackled just as he passed his offensive line there. He was able to get right through him, though. Very, very great run by him. Looks like that's going to conclude the first quarter of this great Massillon-McKinley game. Tigers 7, Bulldogs 6.
We'll be back after this word from Massillon BW3s.
B-Dubs gives you more with buy one, get one free traditional wings on Wing Tuesdays. It's like hitting the lottery twice, right in the mouth. The win-win value lineup at Buffalo Wild Wings. Get takeout or delivery. Hate bones? Love saving money? B-Dubs gives you more with buy one, get one free boneless wings on Boneless Thursdays. So keep the bones in your wallet and out of your chicken. The win-win value lineup at Buffalo Wild Wings. Get takeout or delivery.
We've told you about the Mears must-see guarantee, but don't take our word for it.
They made it clear from the first time I walked in that their job didn't end once they handed me the keys. I service my vehicles here, not only the one I bought here, but my mother's, and the way they treated me with respect, follow-up calls. But the folks here at Mears Nissan treat you that way from start to finish.
See us at 4825 West Tuscarora Street in Canton or online at MearsNissan.com.
Competitive cheer is just that, competitive. Prepare your child now with the help of Perfect Storm All-Stars and their cheer and tumbling facilities right here in Massillon. Perfect Storm All-Stars offers full year, half year, and recreational competitive cheer teams and classes. They feature tumbling, ninja open gyms, baton, birthday parties, and much more. The first class is always free. Call today or stop by their main gym on 3rd Street Northwest in Massillon. Welcome back. Thanks again to Buffalo Wild Wings in Massillon, Mears Nissan, and Perfect Storm All-Stars. Massillon won the blood drive.
A big thank you to Vitality Blood Center, the American Red Cross, McDonald's, Sarda, the Lincoln Auto Group, and CSC Federal Credit Union for making this year a tremendous success. Q92 congratulates and thanks both communities for collecting a total of 208 usable pints of blood that will help people right here in our community.
On behalf of the Q92 Morning Show, thank you for listening and we'll see you next year.
Congratulations to the Tigers for that win. Congratulations to both schools for raising that much blood for the citizens of the Greater Stark County area. As play resumes, it's 1st and 10 Tigers.
We're going to start off the second quarter here. 1st and 10 on the 45-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand out to Camden Beasley, finding an open space down the middle. Going to get tackled at the 40-yard line. Found that very, very small open space, able to gain those few yards for the Tigers. Very, very great run by Camden Beasley. Number 16 on the Massillon Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, hand off to Camden Beasley.
I'm sorry, this is the 16th for the Tigers, and I misspoke. Camden Beasley with the last two carries.
Another gain of yards for the Massillon Tigers. Getting closer to that first down. Bringing them now to third down.
Third down at the McKinley 36.
Third down on the 36-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. He's going to push through.
Quarterback keeps the football. Tackle by.
Looks like it was enough to get that first down for the Tigers on the 35-yard line.
First down, Tigers.
Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Camden Beasley. Finding an open space in that right pocket. Getting past that first down marker for the Tigers. It's a great run by Camden Beasley, number 16 on the Massillon Tigers, once again.
New set of downs for the Tigers from the Bulldogs 21.
Now 1st and 10 on the 21-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Another handoff to Camden Beasley.
Beasley.
Looks like he struggled to push through on that one.
Combining on the tackle, 33, Safaia. Joined by number 52, Elvonte Ivory. Officials timeout.
There's an officials timeout.
Thank you.
Slaughter receives a snap, hand off to Kevin Beasley. Able to gain a few yards for the Tigers. Now third and seven on the 18-yard line for the Tigers with 9 minutes and 22 seconds to go in the second quarter. Slaughter receives a snap. They pass off to the left corner to Austin Brawley, number four. It's like they're going to lose yards. Now fourth and 10 on the 21-yard line. Looks like they're going to go ahead and go for the points here.
Coming up, a 38-yard field goal attempt by number one, Sean Rue.
Number one, Shane Rue on the point attempt here.
Timeout, Massillon Tigers timeout.
We'll be back after this word from Reliable Heating and Cooling.
There was a time when 10 miles to the gallon was acceptable. Today's 40-plus mile per gallon cars weren't even in the rearview mirror back then. Of course, this Lennox air conditioner wasn't on the radar either. It's solar ready, the quietest, most energy efficient air conditioner you can own. It's time to live in the now.
Call Reliable Heating and Cooling for the most advanced technology in heating and air conditioning. When you're ready to live in the now, call Reliable Heating and Cooling.
Lennox, air is life. Make it perfect.
Are you looking for something different? At Friends and Family Credit Union, our success is defined by you. Our goal is to improve your financial needs and better your lifestyle. Friends and Family Credit Union provides loans, savings, checking, and other financial services to anyone who lives, works, worships, or attends school in Stark County. Our friendly staff is fully committed to serving over 11,000 of its members. What are you waiting for? Stop in one of our locations today to become a friend of the family.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Reliable Heating and Cooling and Friends and Family Credit Union.
Well, Shane Rue going to go ahead and kick it for the extra points here. Kick is up. The kick is no good. First and 10 on the 20-yard line for the Bulldogs with 8 minutes and 6 seconds to go in the second quarter. We got Williams back out, filling in for the QB position. Williams receives a snap. A fake handoff. Looks like Nate Watkins is going to break through the offensive line there. Able to make sure they get no extra yards right there. Great breakthrough and a great tackle by Nate Watkins, number 10 on the Tigers. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. passes it over to the left side. It'll be an incomplete pass. Pass intended for number 7, Trayshawn Foster. Looks like he leaped in the air for that one, trying to go for a one-handed catch. Ultimately was incomplete. Now 2nd and 16 on the 14-yard line for the Bulldogs. Sorry, my apologies. 3rd and 16 on the 14-yard line for the Bulldogs. Receives a snap. He's going to try and scramble through the middle. An epic hit and stop by number 4, Austin Brawley. Now, 4th and 8 on the 22-yard line. Looks like they're going to punt this one away. Number 6, Al-Assad, punting off the ball for the McKinley Bulldogs. But number 4, Austin Brawley, and the Massillon Tigers ready to receive the punt.
Delay of gain on the McKinley Bulldogs.
Looks like that one's going to roll out of bounds. The 1st and 10 on the 39-yard line for the Tigers. With 6 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the second quarter, getting closer to wrap up this first half of this great game.
As we approach the midway mark of the second quarter, 1st and 10, Massillon at the 39.
Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Lennox Jr. He's going to drag a few of the Bulldogs on his back to gain the yard for the Tigers.
At the 41, gain of 2, 2nd down 8.
Now 2nd and 8 on the 41-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. It'll be a double handoff, ultimately landing in Austin Brawley's arms. Going to be a fumble by Austin Brawley and a recovery by the McKinley Bulldogs. Looks like the play was reversed. I'm gonna go ahead and call that one, say that he was down before he released the ball out of his arms.
Third and 3, Tigers.
Now 3rd and 3 on the 46-yard line for the Massillon Tigers.
Thank you.
Osweiler receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. He's going to have a deep one down left field. Pass intended for number 13, Riley Campbell. It's going to be incomplete.
There's a flag on the play. Penalties declined.
Now fourth and three on the 46-yard line. Looks like the Tigers are going to punt this one away. Darius McElroy ready to punt this one away for the Massillon Tigers. Punt is caught. Going to be tackled by number 44, Nathan DePue.
Number 95, Ty Boyles, a senior.
Injured player. Dominic Salvino.
First and 10 on the 27-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. With 5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Williams receives a snap, hands it off to Chris Williams. The run up the middle. Going to get tackled just right where they stood. Now second and 10 on the 27-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a fake handoff, a pass. Looks like that one's going to be incomplete.
Pass is incomplete. Intended receiver number 2, Caleb Ruffin, one of the good captains. And on the coverage number 4, Austin Brawley.
4 minutes and 15 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Just about to wrap up the first half of this marvelous game. Tigers 7, Bulldogs 6. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass over in the left corner. Looks like the pass is going to be complete. Pass complete to number 10, Sincere McNeil.
New set of downs for the Bulldogs.
Now first and 10 on the 23-yard line for the Bulldogs with 4 minutes to go in the second quarter. Williams receives a snap. He's going to hand it off to Chris Williams. A run is stripped in the middle. Does not look like they gained any yards on that play. Now second and 10 on the 23-yard line.
Flag.
Second and 5 on the 18-yard line. Williams receives a snap, hands off to Chris Williams, finding an open space in the middle. Gaining an extra 3 yards for the McKinley Bulldogs, reaching the way closer to a Bulldog touchdown. That snap, he's going to hand it off. They're going to get tackled just where they stood. Looks like there's going to be a flag on the play, though. Oh,
multiple flags there. Illegal substitution on Massillon.
Bring us now to second and goal for the Bulldogs. Williams receives the snap. He's going to hand it off to Chris Williams. Looks like he's going to be just shy of the touchdown. The 1 yard line. Now third and goal for the Bulldogs. With 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the second quarter. Williams receives a snap. He's going to push through with a flag.
Massillon.
Looks like they're going to repeat the third down. Ball on the 1 yard line. Williams receives the snap. He's going to hand it off. Looks like it's still not a touchdown, another tackle on the 1 yard line.
We've got a hurt Austin Brawley on the field. Or not Austin Brawley, sorry. Camden Beasley. Camden Beasley. We'll be back after this word from your pizza shop.
Fresh, great-tasting pizza can be difficult to find. Your pizza shop, located on Massillon's west side, has been making delicious pizza since the 1960s. Their large menu includes your favorite pizzas and toppings, along with wings, pressure-fried chicken, oven-baked subs, and more. Their convenient drive-thru window is open. Delivery service is available, too. Your pizza shop, located on the corner of Lincoln Way West and 32nd Street Northwest in Massillon.
Welcome back. Thanks again to your pizza shop. Austin Brawley looks like he hurt an ankle there. Sorry, I keep saying his name's Austin Brawley.
Camden Beasley. There you go.
They're very different.
Ball still on the 1 yard line. Williams receives a snap. Looks like the McKinley Bulldogs are going to get that touchdown. Bring out the kicker to get that extra point for the Bulldogs. Number 6, Al-Assad. The extra point attempt. Kick is up. And the kick is good. Bulldogs now 13, Tigers 7.
We'll be back after this word from Tower Industries.
There's so much special about Massillon. You can't walk down the street without smiling and saying hello to someone who knows you, who knows your family.
In today's society, we're getting fewer and fewer opportunities for families to enjoy each other in an outside activity that is free. We have that.
It's a strong community. People give back. Massillon continues to give back with the residents and businesses to those in need, and it's a great thing to be a part of.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Tower Industries and Downtown Massillon Association.
Coming back from those commercials, we now have 1 minute and 38 seconds to go in the second quarter. McKinley Bulldogs ready to kick it off for Freddie Legs Jr. and Austin Brawley to receive that kickoff in the backfield. Down the field. That catch was by number 11, Zanai Berry on the Massillon Tigers. Now, first and 10 on the 40-yard line for the Tigers with 1 minute and 30 seconds to go in the second quarter. Slaughter receives a snap. There's going to be a flag called on the play.
Bowling. drawing the penalty, ball on the 31-yard line for the Tigers, first down 15.
Now first and 15 on the 31-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here over to the right corner. Catch by number 18, Ardell Banks. Gain those extra few yards for the Massillon Tigers.
Ardell Banks, Jr. from the quarterback, freshman number 2, Jalen Slaughter. Knocked out of bounds by number 19, Maurice Hill of the Bulldogs.
Now second and 3 on the 43-yard line for the Tigers. 1 minute and 25 seconds to go in the second quarter. Slaughter receives a snap. Looks like he's going to go down right away. Bulldogs ended up breaking through that offensive line. Just before he was able to release that ball, he had to go down immediately. Now third and 11 on the 35-yard line. With 55 seconds to go in the second quarter, Bulldogs 13, Tigers 7.
We'll be back after this word from Medicap Pharmacy.
Medicap Pharmacy on Lincoln Way West has been serving our area for over 20 years. They're your local pharmacy that cares about you and your time.
I can get them filled from 5 to 10 minutes. If I go to a chain drugstore, I may have to wait a half hour to an hour.
Probably the best pharmacist in the city.
Hi, I'm Chris Kingsbury, owner and pharmacist at Medicap Pharmacy. Stop in sometime soon, and you can experience our fast and friendly service.
The earth beneath my feet is turning like a wheel.
Your first set of wheels didn't come with complications or strings or hassles. It can be that way again. There's a simpler way to buy tires. A Tire Pros.
We're hassle-free, guaranteed.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Medicap Pharmacy and Discount Tire Outlet.
Now third and 11 for the Tigers on the 35-yard line. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Lennox Jr. He's going to fumble the ball. Able to recover it, though.
There's a flag on the play.
Seconds to go here in the second quarter. Just about to wrap up the first half of this game.
Flag was on McKinley.
It's now first and 10 on the 36-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Lobs it all the way down the field. Pass intended for number 18, Ardell Banks, but it's going to be incomplete. Now 11 seconds to go in the second quarter. second and 10 on the 36-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Going to pass it down the field again. It's going to be intercepted by the McKinley Bulldogs. Pass was intended for number 4, Austin Brawley. Looks like the pass was just a little too far over right. It was intercepted by McKinley Bulldogs. Four seconds to go in the second quarter. Bulldogs 13, Tigers 7. First and 10 on the 20-yard line for the Bulldogs. Like that's going to conclude the first half of this game, folks. Bulldogs 13, Tigers 7.
Thank you. And now, the Tiger Swing Band would like to take you on a trip to the ocean and spend some time at the beach. We begin with a classic Beach Boys hit, Surfing USA, along with the familiar drum beats of Wipeout. Enjoy the sights and sounds of the sea. In the water. Be on the lookout for a boat where we can come sail away. From the Pirates of the Caribbean and the Titanic movie soundtracks. It's a pirate's life for me and an Irish party in third class. We'll be right back.
Tiger Town, the 2021 edition of the Massillon Tigers.
Thank the Massillon Tigers for coming out and doing that wonderful show. They never cease to amaze me and all the rest of the Massillon Tiger fans, doing a great job every single time.
We'll be back after this word from the Massillon Boys and Girls Club.
The Boys and Girls Club of Massillon has been at the forefront of youth development, instilling a sense of competence, usefulness, belonging, and influence. The greatest contributions to the lives of our youth, our communities, our nation, and the world are the life lessons taught every moment of every hour of every club day. The youth of today become the leaders of tomorrow. Great futures start here.
Hello, and welcome to the Stark County Humane Society. Today we're going to give you a few pointers when considering adopting a new furry friend. All animals here at the Stark County Humane Society are spayed, neutered, microchipped, vaccinated, dewormed, and if old enough, heartworm tested for our canine friends. Adopters will receive a free exam within 2 weeks of adoption at local veterinarian hospitals. We encourage all adopters to take full advantage of this. A one-time adoption fee is required for your new furry friend. When you adopt, you get an awesome adoption packet that includes treats for your new fur baby and savings for you. But this is not where the cost of adoption stops. Did you know the average cost of an animal like a new puppy or kitten can cost up to $500 annually? This includes annual veterinarian visits, preventative care, and everyday supplies like crate, litter, food, toys. But I hope this doesn't scare you away. Adopting an animal is a huge responsibility and a commitment. Please take the time to consider the cost of adopting a new pet into your family today. I hope to see you soon at the Stark County Humane Society. Please visit our website or visit us on social media for more information.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Massillon Boys and Girls Club.
Coming back from the halftime show, now Massillon's going to go ahead and kick it off. Number one, Shane Rue kicking off the ball for the Massillon Tigers. McKinley Bulldogs 13 and Massillon Tigers 7 at the start of the third quarter.
Kickoff, number one, Shane Rue.
We're going to catch that kickoff. Start running down the field. Going to get tackled just shy of the 25-yard line. 35-yard line.
The tackle on the play, number five, senior Ryan Zinkovich. So first series, second half, Bulldogs from the McKinley 35.
Now, first and 10 on the 35-yard line for the Bulldogs.
Keaton Rhodey gets the second half start, the sophomore number 15.
Keaton Rhodes starting off the second half of this football game with the QB. Rhodes receives the snap. It's going to be a handoff to Williams.
Like
a slight gain for the Bulldogs.
Gain of a yard, second and nine, ball in
Now second and 9 on the 36-yard line. Rudd receives a snap. Fake handoff. He's going to pass this one. In the left corner. It's going to be an incomplete pass.
On the coverage, number 20, Freddie Lyons Jr. Intended receiver, number 2, senior co-captain, Caleb Ruffin.
Pass intended for number 2, Caleb Ruffin. Now third and 9 on the 26-yard line for the Bulldogs. Rudd receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Passes it off to the left corner, all the way down the field. Looks like that one was very much overthrown. Now fourth and 9 on the 36-yard line. Looks like they're going to punt this one away. Number 6, Al-Assad, as the punter for the Bulldogs.
This includes e-cigarettes and vaporizers. Violation of this regulation is grounds to be removed from the stadium.
We got number 4, Austin Brawley, in the back, receiving the punt from Massillon.
Lassage punt.
I'm going to go ahead and catch that punt there. He's going to run up the field. 50, go to the 40, to the 30, to the 20-yard line. Looks like there's going to be a flag on the play, though.
Holding against the Tigers.
Now first and 10 on the 25-yard line. We got Darius McElroy coming out in QB position for the Massillon Tigers.
Illegal substitution on Massillon.
McElroy receives a snap. He's going to end up running right just a little bit. He's going to get up the field. Gaining yards for the Massillon Tigers. Going right out of bounds. Looks like there's going to be another flag on the play. First and 25, ball on the 10-yard line for the Tigers. McElroy receives a snap. He's going to run through the open space in the middle. Gain some yards for the Tigers. the 21-yard line.
Maurice Hill on the tackle.
Very happy to see no flag on that one.
Yeah.
That was three plays in a row there was a flag on Massillon. Absolutely insane. Second and 14, ball on the 21-yard line. McCoy receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Going off to the right side. Pass intended for number 18, Ardell Banks, who is ultimately incomplete. Looks like it was just too short for him, to be able to actually catch that pass there.
Third and 14.
Looks like they're going to bring Jalen Slaughter back in. Slaughter receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Lobs it down the field. Pass it to 18 Ardell Banks. He's going to catch that ball. Gets tackled at the 20-yard line. Getting a massive amount of yards for the Tigers.
Caleb Ruffin on the tackle.
Very, very good job by Jalen Slaughter finding the open man out of all that chaos.
First and 10, Tigers at the Bulldogs 21.
Now first and 10 on the 21-yard line for the Massillon Tigers with 9 minutes and 35 seconds to go in the third quarter. Darius McAvoy back in. McAvoy receives a snap.
Darius McAvoy
to try and run up the middle. Looks like there was no gain on that play.
33, Nehemiah Sabaia.
Slaughter's coming back in again. Slaughter receives a snap. Fake handoff. He's going to pass it. Incomplete pass. Headed for number 18, Ardell Banks. Very, very close interception. Thank God it was not an interception, but it was very, very close. Ultimately, an incomplete pass for the Massillon Tigers. Now third and 10 on the 21-yard line for the Tigers.
We'll be back after this word from Buell and Oliveri Insurance.
1 minute, you're out there living life to the fullest. The next thing you know, you've got sweeping changes to make and your family's future to think about. Talk to a Grange independent agent about how to save by putting all of your insurance with Grange, protecting your possessions and the ones you love. When things zig instead of zag.
Buell and Oliveri Insurance is your Grange independent agent in Massillon. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, call or visit our website today.
Those were the days, my friend.
I thought they'd never end.
We'd sing and dance.
Forever and a day.
We'd live the life we choose.
We'd fight and never lose.
For we were young.
And yes, those were the days.
T.I.G. E-R-S! T-I-G! E-R-S!
Woo!
It's where we come together, where we are rested, nourished, and renewed. It's where convenience and performance surround the ones we love. It's home. Home Appliance and Whirlpool help homes happen with innovation you can depend on and quality you can trust. Right now, purchase select Whirlpool kitchen and Whirlpool laundry appliances and save. And pay no interest when paid in full within 12 months. Home Appliance, where your home comes together.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Buell and Oliveri Insurance, WHS Alumni Association, and Home Appliance.
Third and 10 on the 21-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Freddie Lennox Jr. So it gets a gain of yards for the Tigers. Looks like that was just enough to get them the Tiger first down. Now first and 10, the ball on the 11-yard line.
Carrier number 20, Freddie Lennox Jr.
We've got a hurt McKinley player. We'll be back after this word from the Massillon YMCA.
I'm Scott Laudermilk, personal trainer at the Massillon YMCA. I have some good news.
I bet you're going to tell them that we've been in the community for over 100 years and we have two locations.
And the YMCA offers financial assistance and income-based pricing, so everyone is welcome.
Remember, we also offer childcare, full and half-day preschool, school day off programs, before and after school, and summer camp.
I was just going to say, we got weights, baby!
Discount Outlet is bringing you the latest and greatest deals you have to see to believe.
We have huge selections at closeout prices for all of your everyday essentials, clothing, toys, home decor, and much more.
When we say tiny prices are a big deal, that means big savings on all of your favorite name brand products.
So come check us out at the original store in Massillon on First Street.
Discount Outlet, where tiny prices are a big deal.
Welcome back. Thanks again to the Massillon YMCA and Discount Tire Outlet. Oops, sorry. Discount Outlet. I'm so sorry.
Looks like Darius McCoy is going to come in for the QB position. McCoy receives a snap. He's going to run up the middle. Able to gain a few yards for the Massillon Tigers. Inching their way closer to another touchdown, hopefully. It's now second and three, ball on the 4-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. McRoy receives a snap. He's going to run through the middle again. Looks like it's going to be a Massillon Tiger touchdown. Darius McRoy finding that open space, running straight through the middle, getting the touchdown for the Massillon Tigers. Rachel, how are you feeling about that one?
I'm doing great. I could breathe a little bit better now.
Yes, I totally agree with that. This entire game has made me very, very nervous. I'm very, very happy to see that the Tigers are leveling out the score now. Hopefully, we'll keep increasing their score to hopefully win this game. Fingers crossed. We got number one, Shane Rue, coming out for the extra point. Kick is up. And the kick is good. Massillon Tigers 14, McKinley Bulldogs 13, with 7 minutes and 58 seconds to go in the third quarter.
We'll be back after this word from Doring Vision Center.
Massillon 14.
Proper eye care is important. Doring Vision Center in downtown Massillon is a primary care optometry clinic. They use the latest technology and can treat most eye disease conditions. Doring Vision Center welcomes emergency eye visits, and same-day appointments may be available. Most insurances are accepted, including government plans. Don't forget their optical showroom, featuring a wide variety of frames.
From everyone at Doring Vision Center,
go Tigers!
Welcome back, thanks again to Doring Vision Centers.
Shane Rue getting ready to kick it off for the Massillon Tigers. Never ceases to amaze the fans. Always does an amazing job kicking off and getting the extra points for the Massillon Tigers. He's done a great job all season. Shane Rue for the Massillon Tigers.
Thank you for McKinley 17. Damon Shelton 26, Chris Williams.
Rue kicks off the ball. Catching that one and run down the field. Going to get tackled just shy of the 25-yard line.
Special team stop for the Tigers, number 12, senior Curtis Miller.
They're going to be first and 10 on the 24-yard line for the Bulldogs. With 7 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the third quarter. Receives a snap.
Maggie, the ball carrier.
It's going to be a handoff. Looks like there's going to be a flag on the play.
Rocio Kirksey, senior, number 24 on the stop. Timeout. McKinley player needs attention.
Injured player on the field. We'll be back after this word from Friends and Family Credit Union.
Are you looking for something different? At Friends and Family Credit Union, our success is defined by you. Our goal is to improve your financial needs and better your lifestyle. Friends and Family Credit Union provides loans, savings, checking, and other financial services to anyone who lives, works, worships, or attends school in Stark County. Our friendly staff is fully committed to serving over 11,000 of its members. What are you waiting for? Stop in one of our locations today to become a friend of the family.
Welcome back, and thanks again to Friends and Family Credit Union.
$500 gas gift card, and you can get your ticket and your winnings behind the McKinley banner.
First and 19 on the 15-yard line for the Bulldogs. Already receives the snap. It's going to be a handoff. Looks like a handoff to number 26, Chris Williams. It's going to be no gain, though, on that play.
At the 14-yard line. Second and 20.
It's now second and 20 on the 14-yard line. Six minutes and 53 seconds to go in the third quarter. Brody receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here over to the right side. It's going to be a complete pass to number 10, Sincere McNeil. For a gain of yards for the Bulldogs.
Junior on the catch. Moving the ball to the 26-yard line. Third down.
Now third and 8 on the 26-yard line for McKinley Bulldogs. with 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Brody receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here over to the strip, the middle. It is picked off by number 4, Austin Raleigh. And he's going to take the Tigers all the way just about right after the 10-yard line, close to the 5-yard line. Amazing pickoff by Austin Raleigh. It was almost like they threw it right to him. Tell the McKinley Bulldogs were definitely struggling to take him down. Now first and 10, the ball on the 8-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. McElroy in. McElroy receives a snap. Running straight to the middle of the open space. And another Massillon Tiger touchdown, but looks like there's also going to be a flag on the play. Hoping that still means it's a touchdown. Saw that flag go up immediately. Looks like the Massillon Tigers got that touchdown still. That is awesome to see. Darius McElroy doing a great job of finding the open spaces right through the middle, running up and getting the Massillon Tigers some more points on the board.
There is a player down.
Today's contest between the McKinley and Massillon designated a feature game nationwide 2021 Great American Rivalry Series. And we want to thank the United States Marines and Brain Box for selecting this game. Don't forget, visit www.greatamericanrivalry.com for the showdown. You can vote for McKinley versus Massillon.
Looks like the Tigers are going to come out to go for the extra point. Number 1, Shane Rue, attempting the extra point for the Massillon Tigers. Kick is up, and the kick is good. Tigers 21, Bulldogs 13, with 5 minutes and 42 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
We'll be back after this word from Mears Nissan.
We've told you about the Mears must-see guarantee, but don't take our word for it.
Well, before we came in to test drive the vehicle, my husband and I had done some research on the website, and we really enjoyed how easy Mears Nissan's website was to use. We weren't really sure at that time because we didn't need to buy a car. Very low key, low pressure, let us, you know, take the weekend to think about it. So it was really easy peasy for us.
See us at 4825 West Tuscarora Street in Canton or online at MearsNissan.com.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Mears Nissan.
Coming back from those commercials, we have Shane Rue ready for the kickoff. Once again, doing a great job, as always.
Mm-hmm.
like they're going to catch kickoff. Someone down the field. Going to get tackled just shy of the 20-yard line. Now first and 10 on the 19-yard line for the Bulldogs with 5 minutes and 34 seconds to go in the third quarter. We've got Amarion Williams coming back in for the QB position for the McKinley Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. A fake handoff. Pass completion. Another tackle just shy of the 25-yard line.
Tackle on the play. Austin Brawley, number four.
Great tackle by number four, Austin Brawley, on the Massillon Tigers.
Gain of four, second down six from the 23.
Now second and six, ball on the 23-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. Maybe a fake handoff. They're going to try and run. An ultimate sack by number 10, Nate Watkins, on the Tigers. Second he saw him, he immediately stopped him. It's a great stop by Nate Watkins, number 10, on the Massillon Tigers.
Ball at the 21, third down, 8.
Now third and 8 on the 21-yard line with 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Williams receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Struggling to find somebody open. He's going to run up through the middle. Going to get tackled on the 35-yard line. Looks like that was enough to get them the first down. Now first and 10 on the 36-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Williams receives the snap, hands it off to Chris Williams. Looks like that's going to be a gain of no yards. A great defensive execution by number 44, Nathan Depew, on the Massillon Tigers. Stopped him immediately. Now second and 10 on the 36-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Struggling to find somebody open. Looks like he's going to get tackled immediately. Gain of no yards for the McKinley Bulldogs. Tackle by number 84, Chase Bond, the Massillon Tigers. Great job of breaking through and making sure he did not gain any yards for that one. Now third and 15 on the 31-yard line with 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Flag on the play.
Third and 10 on the 36-yard line with 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Williams receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Struggling to find somebody open. Has to go through the middle. Looks like they gained about a yard or two for the Bulldogs.
tackling the quarterback, number 24.
It's now 3rd and 10. Fourth and 9 for the McKinley Bulldogs. 1 minute and 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Is up. It's going to be a short one. Austin Gawley's going to pick it up. Getting surrounded by McKinley Bulldogs.
The initial hit recovered by McKinley, number 18. That is Junior Tyler Jenkins.
Be first and 10 on the 15, on the 25-yard line. For the Massillon Tigers with 1 minute and 5 seconds to go in the third quarter. But Darius McElroy coming in for the QB position. McElroy receives a snap, he's gonna run right up the middle. He's able to stiff arm the Bulldogs. Gain about a good yard or two for the Massillon Tigers.
Looks like we got a hurt McKinley player.
Player down for the Bulldogs, number 19, Maurice Hill.
Now 2nd and 9 on the 26-yard line for the Massillon Tigers with 51 seconds to go in the third quarter. Looks like they're going to bring Jalen Slaughter back out for the QB position. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Freddie Lennox Jr. Finds an open space. Hits his way through. Just shy of the 35-yard line, gaining a few yards for the Massillon Tigers. It's a great run.
Three quarters about to be in the books.
Looks like that concludes the third quarter of this great game. Tigers 21, Bulldogs 13.
We'll be back after this word from Tower Industries.
Games on, you could watch a game like this, or you could watch a game like this surrounded by fans just like you at the Erie Street Pub. The game never ends. Open 7 days a week, Erie Street Pub has pub style food at the right price with daily lunch specials. Wednesday is ladies night, and enjoy our large outside bar and patio. What's keeping you from the Erie Street Pub? Just up the road from Genshaft Fields.
What are you waiting for? Come join us at Erie Street Pub.
Welcome back. Thanks again to Tower Industries and Erie Street Pub.
now 3rd-and-3 on the 32-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap, hands it off to Lennox Jr., finds an open space down the middle. Let's go to the 40. Let's go to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5, to the Massillon Tiger touchdown. That was a great execution, finding that open space to get the Massillon Tiger touchdown, taking our lead even higher. Rachel, how are you feeling about that one?
I feel great. I'm so excited.
They're doing a great job. They came back after that first half, and they're really just have a bunch of energy, and they're ready to try and win this game.
I don't know what Coach Nate Moore said to them, but whatever he said, it worked.
A very, very big feeling. Scared the crap out of them.
Probably.
And number one, Shane Rue going for the extra point for the Massillon Tigers. Kick is up. And the kick is good. Massillon Tigers 28, McKinley Bulldogs 13.
We'll be back after this word for Perfect Storm All-Stars.
Competitive cheer is just that, competitive. Prepare your child now with the help of Perfect Storm All-Stars and their cheer and tumbling facilities right here in Massillon. Perfect Storm All-Stars offers full year, half year, and recreational competitive cheer teams and classes. They feature tumbling, ninja open gyms, baton, birthday parties, and much more. The first class is always free. Call today or stop by their main gym on 3rd Street Northwest in Massillon. Welcome back. Thanks again to Perfect Storm All-Stars.
Massillon Tiger's going to kick it off. Number one, Shane Rue.
Set the kickoff. Number one, Shane Rue. Number two, Taylor Brookman, senior co-captain. 17 is Taylor Sheldon Jr.
Catch this kickoff. Starting to run down the field. Looks like it's going to be a fumble and a recovery by the Massillon Tigers. That's going to be a recovery by number 31, Zach Liebler. The second he saw that ball touch the ground, he picked that up right away. Great fumble recovery by number 31, Zach Liebler, on the Massillon Tigers. It's now 1st-and-10 for the Massillon Tigers on the 16-yard line.
That's going to be offsides on Massillon.
First and 15 on the 21-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter receives a snap. Hand off to Frank Lennox Jr.
Frank Lennox Jr. 24 on the tackle is Alex Vasquez.
Looks like that was a possible gain of a yard or two for the Massillon Tigers.
Quarterback now for Massillon.
Got Darius McElroy coming in for the QB position. A second and 15 on the 21-yard line with 11 minutes to go in the fourth and final quarter. McElroy receives the snap. He's going to hand it off to Austin Brawley, number four. He's going to gain a good few yards for the Massillon Tigers.
There's an injured. Oh, no, he got up. He's good. He's good. He's fine.
Definitely worried me for a second, though. So I moved around a little bit on the ground. I was getting worried.
He just got tired. He needed to take a little nap real quick on the field.
It looks like it. A little power nap never hurt anybody, I guess.
You know, everybody loves naps.
Now third and eight on the 14-yard line. McElroy receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. The 13, Riley Campbell, going to be a complete pass and a massive Tiger touchdown once again. That was a great throw and a great pass. Great catch by Riley Campbell. Great throw by number eight, Darius McElroy, finding the open man in the end zone. Getting another Massillon Tiger touchdown. Rachel, how are you feeling about that touchdown?
I'm feeling great. Excited, spectacular, amazing.
Tigers are definitely doing a great job coming back after that first half. Both offensively and defensively, that's for sure. It looks like we did not get that touchdown. I guess there was a flag. Go ahead and repeat third down on that one. Definitely surprised me. McElroy receives a snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Lobs it down the field. Number pass was intended for number 18, Ardell Banks, but the pass was incomplete. Now, 4th and 25 on the 31-yard line. 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Shane Rue is going to come out to try and get those extra points for the Massillon Tigers.
Timeout, Massillon Tigers timeout.
I believe there was a timeout. Massillon called one.
They called one, but they didn't call one because they put the timeout back on the board. So maybe
very
they didn't
confusing.
Call a timeout. I don't know what happened.
Shane Rue's going to have to catch that snap. Looks like it was a very high snap. I think the Bulldogs are going to pick it up.
No.
But it's...
Ball recovery, McKinley, number 27, Sean Perilosi.
Blow the whistle to conclude that play. Very, very confusing play right there. Looks like it was a very, very high snap to the point where it ended up going into Shane Rue's hands, and he was forced to try and run it. brings us now to first and 10 on the 39-yard line for the Bulldogs with 9 minutes and 53 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. First and 10 on the 39-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives the snap. Try and go for a pass here. It's going to be an incomplete pass.
Mario Williams pass incomplete and intended for number 10, Sincere McNeil. Number 10 to play, number 21.
Minutes and 46 seconds to go here in the fourth and final quarter, second and 10 on the 39-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives the snap. Looks like he's going to run it up. Going to get tackled by number 13, Riley Campbell. They were able to gain a few yards for the Bulldogs. Not much. Now third and 6 on the 43-yard line. 9 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Williams receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Looks like it's going to be a complete pass to number 10, Sincere McNeil.
The Massillon 44.
First and 10, the 44-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives the snap. He's going to pass it over. Number 9. A big hit and a takedown. The 45-yard line.
Second down 11.
Now second and 11 on the 45-yard line for the Bulldogs with 8 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter. Williams receives a snap. He's going to hand it off to Chris Williams, number 26. Able to gain a few yards for the McKinley Bulldogs. Sorry, hand off to number 21, Trayton Mackey.
Third and 8, Bulldogs. Massillon 42.
Now third and 8 on the 42-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Williams receives a snap. Looks like there's going to be a flag on the play. Now third and 12 on the 47-yard line for the Bulldogs. Williams receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Struggling to find somebody open.
Marianne Williams passing.
It's going to be an incomplete pass by Williams.
Sincere McNeil.
Going to bring us now to 4th and 13 on the 47-yard line with 7 minutes and 2 seconds to go in the 4th quarter. They're going to punt this one off. Number 6, Al-Assad. But number 4, Austin Brawley on the Massive Tigers ready to receive the punt. Check, that one's going to go out of bounds. Six minutes and 56 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter. It's going to be first and 10, ball on the 35-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. First and 10 on the 35-yard line for the Tigers. Slaughter is the QB. Slaughter receives a snap. Going to be handoff to Lennox Jr. Run right up the middle. Going to be a tackle after a gain of a few yards for the Massillon Tigers. Six minutes and 30 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. Second and 8 on the 37-yard line for the Tigers. So we've got Darius McElroy coming out from QB position there. He's going to run right through the middle. Gain about a good yard or two for the Massillon Tigers.
Senior co-captain Creed Patterson on the stuff.
McElroy receives a snap. He's going to run off to the left side. Come on, gaining yards. For sure, getting that first down for the Massillon Tigers. We're getting pushed out of bounds.
All will be marked at the McKinley 46.
It's going to be first and 10 on the 46-yard line for the Massillon Tigers with 5 minutes and 41 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. McElroy receives a snap. He's going to run up the middle. Gain a few yards for the Massillon Tigers.
Again, the quarterback, Darius McElroy. Senior co-captain, Trey Patterson on the stop.
Now second and 5 on the 41-yard line for the Massillon Tigers with 5 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter.
I don't know what that was. Don't even ask me what it was.
I got very confused by that one. Second and 10 on the 46-yard line for the Tigers. 4 minutes and 49 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Receives a snap. He's going to run up the middle. Finding an open space. Getting down the field to the 20. To the 15-yard line. To the Tigers. Great job finding that open space. Getting farther and farther down the field. Getting closer to a Massillon Tiger touchdown. Doing a very, very great job of finding those open spaces on the runs that he's doing. Certainly doing his job as a senior QB. Looks like they're going to bring Jalen Slaughter back out, filling the QB position. Slaughter receives the snap. Hand off to Freddie Lennox Jr. Finds a space in the middle. Able to gain a few yards for the Massillon Tigers.
I think he...
Looks like he might be injured. I saw him go head first into one of the McKinley Bulldogs.
He kind of lost grip of the ball. The way he fell back onto the ball was very weird, so he may have just like fallen weird. So. Oh, was two players down. I didn't even notice. We've got Todrick Lee down as well.
Hoping they can both recover from this and be able to get him walk off the field.
Well, looks like Todrick has a bloody nose. But he's just laying down on the field today, I guess. Jeez, we got another one. It's just Massillon nap time, I guess.
I suppose. I can't tell if they're actually injured at this point or if they're just like stretching their legs or what's going on.
I think Woods was getting his legs stretched out there. But
hoping that Freddie Lennox Jr. can get up and walk off the field.
I think he's complaining about his hand.
Looks like it's some kind of grip issue almost.
Number 20, Freddie Lennox Jr.
Well, I hope he's okay.
Three minutes and 37 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Second and two, ball on the 7-yard line for the Massillon Tigers. Got Darius McElroy back out on the field. McElroy receives the snap. Over to the right side. Again, a few yards for the Massillon Tigers. We're getting tackled out of bounds.
Tackle number 24, sophomore Alex Vasquez.
Looks like that was just enough to get them the first down. First and goal, ball on the 5-yard line. McElroy receives a snap, almost fumbles it there.
The captain, Darius McElroy.
Looks like that was about a yard gain for the Massillon Tigers.
Stephen McNeil, number 89.
Two minutes and 57 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter. Tigers 28, Bulldogs 13. Looks like Darius is down on the field.
I think he just got, maybe, got tackled pretty hard. Maybe he
just got winded, maybe. That's what I'm hoping for. If he could just get up and walk up off the field. Steadily.
Nice hand.
Very, very good to see. Glad that he's okay.
Darius McElroy.
Two 2 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. It's going to be second and three. Ball on the three-yard line. Slaughter coming in. Slaughter receives a snap. Fake handoff. 44, Nathan Pugh. Looks like that was a small gain of yards for the Massillon Tigers.
Number 8, Brian Foster Jr. on the stop.
2 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter, about to conclude this great game. Tigers 28, Bulldogs 13. The ball is on the 2-yard line. Slaughter receives a snap. They hand it off to Nathan DePue. He's run over to the left side. He's going to run it in for a massive Tiger touchdown. That was a great run by Nathan DePue. Almost getting tackled, but able to evade that tackle. And run it in for a massive Tiger touchdown. Rachel, how are you feeling about that?
Great. Love massive Tiger touchdown.
You always love to see the massive Tiger touchdowns. You love to see the band go off every single time they score that touchdown. It's always a great feeling. Brings a bunch of serotonin to your body, that's for sure.
Yes.
We got Shane Rue going for the extra point here. The kick is up. The kick is good. Massillon Tigers 35, McKinley Bulldogs 13. 1 minute, 52 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter.
It's been a great game.
They have done so well for the second half to come back after that, after how rough the first half was, to just come back and just absolutely demolish. And constantly put some points on the board. Doing a great job, that's for sure.
You know what Massillon fans should do, Zach?
What?
They should tune in every Wednesday night for the Nate Moore Show on channel 6, 11, and 11.
I think that's a great idea.
I think so, too. You get to hear Coach Moore talk about the team and how they did that week.
As well as plans for the next game, too.
Yes.
It's always a great show. Make sure you guys tune in. Shane Rue kicking it off for the Massillon Tigers.
Back deep, number 1, Davion Winston, number 17, Galen Shelton.
Catch the kickoff. Starts run up the field. Gonna get tackled just shy of the 40-yard line.
Tackled by number 33, that sophomore Cody Finn.
1 minute and 43 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. It's gonna be first and 10 on the 37-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Keaton Rohde coming out, the QB position. Brody receives the snap. He's going to go for a pass here. Struggling to find somebody. Looks like he's going to get tackled.
The ball carrier quarterback, Susan Rudy, the tackler, number 80.
Going to get tackled by number 80, Maverick Clark, on the Massillon Tigers. Great job of breaking through that offensive line, getting that tackle right away. Brody receives a low snap. Oh, it looks like he was not able to catch that one. He was able to recover it. Looks like it was a very low snap. Point where it just touched his hands. 45 seconds to go in the fourth and final quarter. Tigers 35, Bulldogs 13. It's going to be third and 17 on the 30-yard line for the McKinley Bulldogs. Brody receives the snap. He's going to hand it off. A run right up the middle. He's going to get tackled just shy of the 45-yard line. Getting down to about 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Looks like that concludes a Massillon-McKinley game. The Massillon Tigers win 35, McKinley Bulldogs 13. That was an epic game for sure. First half had me a little worried. They were very, very close. But the Tigers ultimately were able to pull it off. As Austin Brawley comes by on the bell, ringing that bell, very, very loud and proud.
Being pulled by Tajamir Nash, number 72.
As well as Todrick Lee. It's an amazing sight to see. We get to keep that bell for another year. You can see how happy the Tiger fans, the Tiger players are to get that win. Beat McKinley.
It's a great day at Massillon.
Posing for a bunch of pictures out there on the field. We'd love to see it.
I'm so excited. This is the, I believe, sixth game in a row that we have won against McKinley.
And at first, I didn't know how many we won in a row until I saw everybody on the field holding up the number six during
number
their
six.
Picture. You know, I was like, wait,
go.
What is it again? Oh, six. Okay.
It's six. There you go. There they all are.
Love to see it.
Posing.
That's going to be a great picture, that's for sure.
Can't even see the bell at this point. There's
oh,
so
no.
many of them. Oh, it's over there.
There's
there
the
it
bell.
Is.
Ardell Banks hopping on that bell right there. We're going to ring that bell all the way off the field.
Running over to the student section.
Thank you.
a great day for Massillon.
That's for sure. Love to see all the smiling faces.
Especially for their seniors. They went all 4 years without losing to McKinley.
The 2021 Great American Rivalry Series presented by the United States Marines. We'd now like to honor today's most valuable player and award the winning team the Great American Rivalry Series Championship Trophy, commemorating their outstanding performances. First, they would like to recognize the most valuable player. As part of this series, ballots were distributed to members of the media in attendance for the selection of the game MVP. A little pause for the ceremony to announce the winner.
Down there. Passing out the hats. I got a couple of those laying around in my room. Got a lot of brothers.
Saw Shane Rue out there scream, "This is my fourth one," out there on the field.
He is right. All of our seniors out there on the field, this is their fourth win against McKinley. They get to graduate undefeated.
It's got to be an amazing feeling for not only the football players, but just for all the senior students. I know that is a great feeling for me as well as Rachel.
Yes. Getting their hats on, posing for pictures.
Love to see it.
I haven't seen Camden Beasley since he went off with an injured foot or ankle, so I hope he's doing okay. Oh, wait, I see him. I see him. Never mind.
Looks like he was almost hit by all the coaches and everybody on the end. Great to see him out on the field after that injury.
Yes. It's like a little Where's Waldo? You just gotta look for the player you're looking for.
Very difficult in the midst of this massive crowd, that's for sure. They are the rivalry champions for the 1,000th game.
Getting ready for another picture. Putting all up that six.
All the seniors getting a bunch of good pictures and memories. Hopefully tell and show their children one day. Talk to them about how seniors are getting through and graduating, not losing to McKinley.
Yeah. kind of get some promotion in there too, I guess.
Oh yeah. As much as you possibly get in that photo.
There you go. They're handing out drinks to players for another picture.
Very, very excited for that one. You could definitely see how excited he is for that. Big thank you to the WHS-TV crew for helping out and filming and everything on cameras. We had Alex Wallace, Lillian Perry, and Willie Buchanan. I am Zach Hamilton, your play-by-play announcer, joined here with Rachel Wuske, your color commentator. Also, big thank you to our directors, Mr. DeWald, Mr. Rock, and Mr. Farrell. Thank you so much for tuning in. Once again, the final score, Massillon Tigers 35, McKinley Bulldogs 13.
This is the world today. Live your life engaged. MCTV delivers innovative technology backed by superior customer service to keep you engaged with family and friends, school, fun, and the outside world. We provide reliable internet, home cable service, phone and home security that keep your life engaged, no matter what's thrown your way. MCTV, we go the extra mile.